Hey guys, welcome back to this SQL tutorial course. In this session, we will learn about transactions in SQL. So a transaction is basically a group of commands which change data stored in a database. And a transaction is treated as one single unit. So this transaction basically ensures that either all of these commands are executed successfully or none of them is. So let's say if one of the commands in the transaction fails, then all the commands will fail and any data which was modified in the database will be rolled back. Similarly, if all the commands inside the transaction execute successfully, only then the transaction will be committed. So this is how transactions ensure integrity of data. So now I'll begin a transaction, and inside that transaction, I'll try to update this age value from 45 to 30. So let me write the syntax to begin a transaction. So I'll type begin, and then type transaction. And inside this, I'll give all of those SQL statements which either have to be committed or rolled back. So over here, I'll give the update statement. I'll type update and then give the name of the table, which would be employee, set eAge to be equal to 30, where eName is equal to Sam. So I'll select these two statements and I'll execute them. So we see that one row has been affected. So now let me have a glance at the modified table. So I'll type select star from employee. I will select this command over here. I'll execute this. Right, so we see that initially the age value was 45. And after we applied this update command, the age has been changed from 45 to 30. Now, since this command is inside a transaction, we have the option to either roll back this command or commit this command. So now let me go ahead and actually roll back this transaction. So to do that, I'll type rollback transaction. So now let me select this. I'll click on execute. So we see that the commands have been completed successfully. Now let me again have a glance at the employee table. Right. So since we have rolled back the transaction, we see that the age value has gone back to the original value, which is 45. So initially using the update command, we had changed the age value from 45 to 30. And after that, we had rolled back the transaction. Now what I'll do is, I'll execute these two statements again. And let me have a glance at the table. Right, so again, we see that the age has been changed to 30. So this time, instead of rolling back the transaction, I will commit the transaction. So I'll type commit transaction. So I'll select this. I'll click execute. Now, let me have a glance at the table. So this time, the transaction has been committed and the change is permanent. So this is how we can either commit or roll back the commands using a transaction. Now, let's look at another example. So in this example, we are using transactions inside the try catch block. So over here, we are beginning the try block and inside this, we are beginning the transaction. And inside the transaction, we are trying to update the salary value to be equal to 50, where the gender value is equal to male. So wherever the gender is equal to male, we'll update that salary value to be equal to 50. Similarly, wherever the gender value is equal to female, I will change that salary value to be 195 divided by 0, which would give us an undefined value. And after that, we'll commit this transaction and print transaction committed. Now, since we have put this transaction inside the try block, if any error occurs, that will be sent to the catch block and we will roll back the transaction. So over here, we see that we are dividing 195 with 0. And since this gives us an undefined value, we will get an error. And that error will be handled in this catch block and we will roll back the transaction. So let me execute this. So you see that the transaction has been rolled back because we get an error inside the try block. Now what I'll do is, I will remove this divided by 0 and run this command again. So this time we see that the transaction has been committed because there was no error inside the try block. So now let me have a glance at the modified employee table. So I'll type select star from employee. I'll select this. I'll click on execute. Right. So we see that we have changed the salary value to be 50, where gender is equal to male. Similarly, I have changed the salary value to be equal to 195, where the gender is equal to female. This is how we can work with transactions in SQL. So thanks for attending this session, guys. Hope you enjoyed it.